Good morning, all of you. Today we are going to discuss another accounting standard. So under FAR syllabus. So first, I would like to remind what are the areas that we have already discussed. Under accounting standards, we have already discussed property, plant, and equipment standard LKS 16 and intangible asset LKS 38. Then accounting policies and accounting estimate errors and the changes under LKS 8 we have already discussed, right? So then today we are going to discuss LKS 23 borrowing cost is another very important standard for your exam. The borrowing cost, why there is another separate standard called borrowing cost? Because you know that so normally if you borrowed the money from bank or any other financial institution, right, you have to incur some additional cost. So that additional cost normally we can identify as an interest. So then the interest and other related cost we can say is a borrowing cost. But in this standard has given the separate definition what is the meaning of borrowing cost, and the special concept for this standard also we should discuss. And the borrowing cost according to the LKS 23 the borrowing cost mean borrowing cost are the interest and other cost that are that an entity incurs in connection with the borrowing of funds. Borrowing of funds. Right. According to this definition, you can identify the borrowing cost are the interest and other cost that are directly connected with borrowing of funds, right? In practice also, we can see the normal word we are using for the extra cost for the borrowing is the interest cost. Then in our general practice in accounting, so normally the interest cost we should identify to the income statement as a finance expense, right? If you have borrowed the funds from bank or any other financial institution for the business purpose, so definitely you want to settle that loan with the extra cost. So that extra cost we can identify as interest. So then that interest normally ordinary expense, that means the revenue nature expenditure. So normally you have to charge to the P&L. That means the journal entries, accrued expense credit, and interest expense should be debit under the finance expense in income statement. Then why we want to discuss this borrowing cost as a separate standard? That is the important thing. This standard explain about another accounting treatment related to borrowing cost if some conditions are satisfied. So then what are the condition? So then what is the accounting treatment? What is the alternative accounting treatment explained in this standard? So then the borrowing, you can understand what is the meaning of the borrowing cost. So according to this definition, then we will discuss the what is the recognition criteria. What is the recognition criteria and what is the accounting treatment related to this borrowing cost according to the LKS 23? It says an entity shall capitalize the borrowing cost that are directly attributable to acquisition construction or production. Of a qualifying asset as a part of the cost of that asset. So this is the accounting treatment, right, explained in this LKS 23 related to borrowing cost. It says entity shall capitalize. Yes, capitalize is a very important word. The borrowing cost that are directly attributable, that means directly incurred or directly related to what? Acquisition, construction or production of a qualifying asset. Right. The qualifying asset as a part of the cost of that asset. Right. So as I explained, the general accounting treatment for the qualifying asset is the borrowing cost is always we should recognize as expense to the P&L. But this standard says if you have incurred any borrowing cost, that means interest cost, because of some borrowed funds, right? So then that borrowed funds, if you have utilized or used directly for what? For the acquisition, construction or production of a qualifying asset, then without charging to the P&L, you can capitalize that cost as a part of the cost of that asset. Right. So then standard says what? Yes, the borrowing cost without charging to the P&L as an expenditure, then this borrowing cost you can add to the qualifying asset, or that means capitalize on that asset, right? If that borrowing cost has incurred to the qualifying asset only, right? So then you can understand. Then this capitalization of borrowing cost you can do only related to the qualifying asset. Then we should discuss the next, then what is this qualifying asset, right? It is very important to practice this accounting treatment related to LKS 23. You should clearly identify what is the nature of this qualifying asset according to the LKS 23. So then, according to this LKS 23, qualifying asset, it has defined qualifying asset mean is an asset that necessary takes a substantial period of time to get ready for intended for its intended use or sale. Right. Then what is this qualifying asset? Qualifying asset is an asset, right? It's an asset. The necessary takes substantial period of time. Yes, it's an asset and it will take substantial period of time, considerable period of time. For what purpose? To get ready to its intended use or sale. Right. Then what are the example according to this definition? How you can identify out of that all assets? So what are the qualifying asset? Because you know that in a balance sheet, the total asset related to business we can divide it into two: non-current asset and current asset. Then what are the example for non-current asset? All property, plant and equipment, building, land, motor vehicles and office equipment, computers, we can identify. And also in addition to that, intangible asset, computer software. You know that I have explained about the intangible asset. Very practical example for the intangible asset in accounting is a computer software like ERP system. Then if you come to the current asset, the inventory, debtors, right, cash and cash equivalent, so other prepayment also we can identify as a current asset. So those are the example for asset related to the business. Then out of these all non-current and current assets, then how you can identify this qualifying asset subject to this definition? Yes, then you must take all these assets and you have to apply this definition. So what are the assets? It will take considerable period of time. For what purpose? To ready for my required use or sale. Sometimes you know that if you identify any physical item or any item as an asset, then it how it become asset, it should be used in your business, and it should be able to use for a long period of time in case of the non-current asset. But you know that in case of the current asset like inventory, we are not keeping that asset for our business. That means the use inside in the organization, we are keeping that asset for the purpose of resale in the near future. So that's why we identify that item as an inventory. So then according to that, the general definition related to the classification related to asset, so what type of asset we can identify as a qualifying asset? Then according to the standard, the example for qualifying assets, we can say inventories. Yes, inventories also become a qualifying asset, but it should fulfill this definition. Then manufacturing plant or building, we can say intangible asset also. Intangible assets. Then we'll take this example. So how this example become a qualifying asset according to this definition? First, I will take this manufacturing plant. Manufacturing plant mean, for example, I will take okay, building, right? So you carry out some business activity for a long period of time. So then you want to expand your business, for example. Then you are looking for another building, right, to expand your business and in a particular area, right? So then, so according to your capacity, you know what is the size of that building. Then to get that building, you have two options. Then if you want, you can search in the market, right? So what are the building available according to your requirement? Then you can purchase already constructed one. That is the first option. Purchasing already constructed one according to your requirement. Then what is the second one? Yes, sometimes there is another option for you. You can find the land and you can construct your own building, right? Your own building. So you can prepare your own plan with the architecture. So then you can construct your own building, and by giving the contract to the contractor, building constructor. So then out of these two options, if you apply to this definition, qualifying asset definition, so what is the option fulfilled according to this definition? For example, if you purchase already constructed one, that means it is already completed. That building is up to your requirement. It will not take more time to get your you become owner of that asset, right? But if you think, no, without purchasing already constructed one, you are going to construct new building according to your plan, then what happened? To get ready that building according to your requirement, it will take times. So the time will be depend the size of that building and according to your requirement, right? So then what happened if you apply that two option, whether you are going to purchase already constructed one or whether you are going to construct new building? So out of that two option, what is the option become a qualifying asset? We will apply now. The asset take building, it will take necessarily take substantial period of time. If you purchase already constructed one, it will not take more time. But if you are going to construct new building, yes, it will take some considerable period of time. According to the size of that building, sometimes it will take 6 month time, 1 year period, 2 year period, 3 year period. Standard not mentioned, what is the substantial period mean? According to your requirement and according to the nature of the asset, the substantial period will depend. So then what happened? For why it will take 6 month time or 1 year period or 2 year period? Because get ready for its intended sale, use or sale. Now the building you are going to construct, for what purpose? For the use of your business, not for sale. Then it become but asset, and after you complete it, you can identify that asset as a property, plant and equipment, right? So whatever the example given in your exam to identify the qualifying asset, apply these features given in this definition of qualifying asset. Definitely it should be an asset, and it should take substantial period of time to get ready for is intended sale or use. Then how this inventory also become a qualifying asset? Inventory mean what? Inventory also the asset, but you keep that assets for the purpose of sale in future, not for your not for the business usage. So then inventory also sometimes become a qualifying asset. Why? For example, you are a manufacturer of generators, big generators. Sometimes you are manufacturing that power generators, the power generating unit we call the generator. So then the generator according to the customer requirement. Then one of the customer has given the order for you to manufacture to new generator. then to construct that generator according to your production capacity, it will take 1 month period. So then what happened? So that generator you are manufacturing not for your usage, it's for the purpose of sale according to the order. You have received some advance payment also. Then how? Yes, that generator also become asset. Then now it is not already manufactured, so it will take 1 month period. Then substantial period is what? 1 month period for intended what? To fulfill your customer requirement for the purpose of sale. Why you are manufacturing that generator? Not for your use, it is for sale. The order received from the customer. So then that's how that's why inventories also become a qualifying asset. So then we can take this inventory as example how this inventory become a qualifying asset according to my explanation. Manufacturing plant also I explain this by taking building, right? So then intangible asset also you can identify. For example, you are looking for ERP system. Currently you are using manual system in your organization. Now you want to integrate this all activities in your organization. For example, finance, accounting, marketing and production, all you want to take into the one system. Then it will save your time and money all. So then in that case, you are looking to develop ERP system in your organization. So then you have two options. If you want ERP system, then that already developed one you can purchase from outside. Or otherwise, the new ERP system you can build in your organization. So in that case, apply this example, this definition to identify what are the intangible asset become qualifying asset. Then for example, the intangible asset then that ERP system, if you are going to purchase already developed one from outside, then it not become a qualifying asset. Because why? It has already fulfilled your intended requirement. But if you are going to develop new ERP system inside in your organization, right? Now it is not up to your requirement. It will take some period of time. So then to fulfill your requirement, if you are going to develop new ERP system in your organization with the resources, with the available resources. So that's how you have to apply whatever the example given in your examination to identify the qualifying asset. Now you can understand what is the meaning of qualifying asset with the example. Now again I am coming to the fundamental principle in this LKS 23. Why we discuss this qualifying asset? Because this LKS 23 says what? The borrowing cost, the interest cost you incur related to borrowing of funds. For what purpose? If you have used or going to use to either acquisition mean to purchase, or construct like building, or to production like the generator I explained, of a qualifying asset, then that accounting treatment is what? That borrowing cost without charging to P&L, you can capitalize on this asset, right? So therefore, to apply this accounting treatment explained in this LKS 23, you should have very clear idea about qualifying asset. Right. So then under this LKS 23, I explain what is the meaning of borrowing cost. So any cost you incur directly related to borrowing of funds in connection with the borrowed funds, we can say is a borrowing cost. Example is interest cost. Then the general accounting treatment related to borrowing cost is always we should charge to the P&L as expenditure under the finance cost. But LKS 23 explained if that borrowed cost you have incurred related to qualifying asset, then without charging to P&L, that borrowing cost or interest cost also you can add to the qualifying asset. That means what is the journal entry? The identify what is the total borrowing cost incurred during the period related to borrowed funds. If that borrowed funds you have used to qualify in asset, then the journal entry or accounting treatment is the borrowing, the interest cost you should add to the asset as a part of the cost of that asset, then the incurred, if you incurred in cash or if it is not incurred still, so then you can credit to the cash or accrued expense account, right? That means the finally what is the journal entry? Qualifying asset debit, credit to the cash if you have already paid. If it is not paid, you can credit to the accrued expenditure, right? So in my TUT, so I have given these all definitions and the recognition criteria also. You have to underline what is the interest and under the borrowing cost, interest and other cost connected with the borrowing of funds. Then I have given the qualifying asset definition also. The very important, it should be asset, right? So then it will take substantial period of time for what? Intended use or sale. What are the example? Inventories, manufacturing plant, intangible asset, and investment property also, right? So then according to very the important area is the recognition criteria. Entity shall capitalize the borrowing cost, underline the word capitalize, borrowing cost directly attributable to acquisition and construction of or production of qualifying asset as a part of the cost of that asset. Then entity shall recognize other borrowing cost as expenses in the period in which it is incurred. That means that's why according to this LKS 23, you can capitalize only the borrowing cost you incurred to the qualifying asset, only you can capitalize. But all other borrowing cost you have to apply the general accounting treatment, as I explained, always charged to the P&L as a part of the interest cost, right? Then how you can apply this recognition criteria? Then we have to compute, we have to calculate what is the method. So what is the method of calculating the borrowing cost to capitalize the capitalize as a part of the qualifying asset, right? The next step is computation of borrowing cost for the capitalization. Right. The computation of borrowing cost for capitalization, right? Yes, according to the standard, the when you are going to identify the borrowing cost for capitalization, we should be able to divide into two, right? Number one, the specific borrowing according to the nature of your borrowed funds, we can identify the first one is specific borrowings. Specific borrowing. Second one, a general borrowings. Right. Specific borrowing mean, right, according to the explanation given, under the borrowing cost eligible for the capitalization, the first para, to extend that an entity borrows the funds specifically, very important, highlight the word, specifically, for the purpose of obtaining the qualifying asset, the entity shall determine the amount of borrowing cost eligible for the capitalization as at the actual borrowing cost incurred on the borrowing during the period, less any investment income on the temporary investment of this borrowing. Yes, when you are going to calculate the borrowing cost that to be capitalized on the qualifying asset, if that borrowing is a specific borrowing, right, so then amount you should calculate, identify what is the total borrowing cost incurred during the period, total borrowing cost incurred during the period minus the temporary investment income, temporary investment income, right. The specific borrowing mean what? For example, you need a building, right? You have given your plan to the contractor, and contractor says, okay, this to complete this entire building, I want 50 million. Then that 50 million is the cost of this building. So then what happened? You don't have money. So you asking entire 50 million from a bank as a loan in order to construct this building, right? Now this building you are going to construct for the purpose of use for your future business, right? So in that case, this building, it is not already constructed, so therefore is going to construct. Then contractor say it will take 1 year period, total cost is 50 million, so time to time you have to pay that amount to the contractor to complete your building. So then you can understand that entire 50 million rupee you are going to borrow from the bank. So then it become entire 50 million become a borrowed fund. So then that building also going to complete according to your requirement, it will take 1 year period. Now you can understand that building also complete the definition of qualifying asset, because why? It is an asset, it will take necessary substantial period of time, 1 year period, to complete as a building according to your purpose. So then that entire building, the entire 50 million you have borrowed, you are completely used for the that building only. So then we can say in that kind of example, it is an specific borrowing. That means if you have borrowed total borrowed amount, if you are utilizing, if you are using only for the qualifying asset, then that borrowing we call is an specific borrowing. In that situation, to identify the amount to be capitalized, amount, the borrowing cost, the borrowing cost for capitalization, how you can calculate, identify what is the total borrowing cost incurred during the period. For example, as I explained, you have borrowed 50 million, right? Total the borrowed funds borrowed amount is 50 million. The interest rate 10% per annum, right? So then what happened? If you have used this entire 50 million during the period, right, your total borrowing cost incurred during the period become what? 50 million multiply 10%, right? So then your borrowing cost become 5 million, right? Become 5 million. And the temporary investment, the temporary investment income is, for example, that entire you can get at the beginning entire 50 million from the bank, but you have agreed with the your contractor to complete your building. You are not required to pay entire 50 million in advance to the contractor. So according to the agreement with the contractor, you want to pay that 50 million step by step. For example, at the beginning you want to pay out of that 50 million 10% as the as advance, then you pay only 5 million. Then according to the completion, according to the completion of that building, you want to pay to contractor. So then, for example, at the end of the first 1 year, so you have to pay entire 50 million. Then what happened? Now in your account, you have received already entire 50 million from the bank as a loan. Then, but you want to pay only initially the 5 million to the contractor. Then you have balance, for example, 45 million. Then why you are keeping that 45 million in your bank account? Then you can invest that 45 million temporary in a short term investment, right? So for example, then after another 3 months, contractor asking another 10 million. So then another, at the end of the fourth month, he may ask another 5 million. So like that, you want to pay entire 50 million step by step to the contractor. Then during that period, the balance amount, what you can do, you can invest in a short term investment opportunities. You can find the investment opportunities. For example, you can, the balance amount you can invest into 1 month fixed deposit. Then you can get some interest interest on that. So then that kind of practice, if you have applied, then what happened during that 1 year period, because of that investing that balance amount in your fixed deposit or any other short-term investment opportunities, right, you may get some another 500,000 temporary investment income. Then to identify the borrowing cost for capitalization, right, according to this example, 50 million you received as a bank loan, it is subject to 10% per annum, right? Then that mean entire year you are liable to pay 10% to the bank. Then total borrowing cost is 5 million. Then balance amount you have invest temporary in a fixed deposit or any other investment opportunities, then total amount you have received as in investment income 500,000. Then finally, the what is the borrowing cost to be capitalized? Only 4.5 million amount. 4.5 million amount. So this is the way you want to calculate the borrowing cost for capitalization in case of the specific borrowing, right? Now what is the general borrowing mean? General borrowing mean, now you have borrowed funds, you have used the funds for your qualifying asset by using that all the funds out of that different kind of funds that you have taken into the business, not a specific one. Now take this same example. Yes, you are going to construct the building, right? You are going to construct the building, right? To complete this building, it will take again 1 year period. 1 year period. You want 50 million rupee subject to 10% per annum. You want 50 million, right? Then, now in this situation, when you compare with specific borrowing, in case of the general borrowing, now you are not going to take entire 50 million as a separate bank loan subject to some interest rate. For example, you have already taken 25 million short-term loan. Let's see, to the 10%, if it is a short-term loan, the interest rate, for example, 15% per annum, 25 million. You have taken another 10 million as a long-term loan, right? Long-term loan for a 5 years period. Interest rate is 10% per annum. Now total fund is 35 million. So then you have asked, you have another 25 million overdraft facility. The 35, 25, you can identify as a total amount is 60. So then out of that 60 million, in case of borrowing funds, the general borrowing, as I explained, to you need 50 million, you need 50 million for qualifying asset. Qualifying asset, right? You need 50 million for qualifying asset. But you have borrowed the funds, the details of borrowed funds, the short term loan, let's see, we will take short term loan 20 million, right? Long term loan 30 million. Another overdraft facility, you have taken another 10 million, right? Let's see, 20 million, right? Now your total amount of your borrowed funds used during the period is 70 million. 70 million. But you need only 50 million to complete this qualifying asset. That means the building during this period. Let's see, now you have complete this entire building during this year, right? But how you have used this 50 million? Because you have taken short term loan 20 million, long term loan 30 million, overdraft facility 20 million, total amount 70 million. This loan, all these loan you have taken not only for the purpose of this qualifying asset, with some other requirement also. For example, if you check with the proposal given for the short term loan to bank, in case of this 20 million, you have mentioned, yes, part of this money we are going to use for the building, for our qualifying asset. Same, the part of the funds we are using for our working capital purpose also. For example, to settle the creditors and to purchase the inventories, like that. Long-term loan also, you have mentioned part of this long-term loan, we are going to purchase some machineries to the business. In addition to some part of the funds, we are planning to use this qualifying asset also. Overdraft facility, you know that, is a common facility. Normally, we are using for the working capital purpose. But during the period, if you check all your accounts, part of this 20 million, you have used for this qualifying asset also. Now, problem is, but all these borrowed funds are subject to different interest rate, different borrowing cost. That means the annual interest cost. What is the other word we can use now for the interest cost? The borrowing cost. The borrowing cost. Short term loan, you have taken, as I explained, 15% per annum. And long term loan, 10% per annum. Overdraft facility, you know that, it is also 15% per annum, right? Now different borrowing cost and different amounts, right? So then short term loan you have taken 20 million, long term loan you have taken 30 million, overdraft facility you have taken 20 million. But total amount of the borrowed funds is 70 million. But out of this 70 million, you have used 50 million for this qualifying asset also. then how you can identify? But in practically you can't identify what is the amount of this 20 million you use for the qualifying asset. What is the amount you use out of this 30 million use for this qualifying asset? Overdraft facility, what is the amount used? Practically difficult to identify, because when the contractor asks money, so you are giving money out of this total funds. But this all this borrowed amount also subject to different interest rate. So then in that case, this is the example we can say general borrowing. Yes, we have used some borrowed funds for the qualifying asset, but not that borrowed funds taken specifically from the bank. We have used some borrowed funds out of this total funds taken to the company with the different purpose, we can use it. So then what happened? So this, in case of this general borrowing, then we want to identify to identify the borrowing cost, right? We should be able to calculate another very important capitalized the term called capitalization rate. Capitalization rate mean what? It says capitalization rate mean a weighted average. The capitalization rate shall be the weighted average of the borrowing cost right? Weighted average of the borrowing cost. That's why now if you have used some borrowed funds to the qualifying asset, right, out of this total, the out of the general borrowings, right? So that means general borrowing means this borrowed funds is not 100% used for this qualifying asset. Part of these funds you have used for and other activities of the business also. For example, to purchase again inventory, settle the creditors, and to purchase other type of assets. So then, but finally you can't identify what are the total out of these funds, what is the amount one by one used for this qualifying asset. So in that case, you want to calculate the general borrowing cost, the one specific borrowing cost subject to this general borrowing. Then we call is a capitalization rate. Capitalization rate mean but weighted average of the borrowing cost. Weighted average of the borrowing cost. Then what is, how we can calculate the general the capitalization rate related to this example, right? As I explained, so I need 50 million. I need 50 million for construct building, construct a building, then it become a qualifying asset according to this LKS 23. Then during the period to construct this building, so we have these funds, we have used these funds: short term loan 20 million, long term loan 30 million, overdraft facility 20 million, right? Now I want to calculate what is the borrowing cost to be incurred during this period related to this qualifying asset. then standard says yes, you have to calculate capitalization rate. Then capitalization rate is the weighted average amount of the borrowing cost. Then how you can calculate the capitalization rate related to this example? The capitalization rate equal take total of borrowing cost, the actual borrowing cost incurred during the period, actual borrowing cost incurred during the period, divide total borrowings. That means what is the actual borrowing cost incurred during the period? You have taken short term loan 20 million subject to 15% per annum, plus you have taken 30 million long term loan subject to 10% per annum. That means 30 10%, then again another 20 million. We will consider that entire 20 million we use during the period, total full amount, then 15% per annum plus 20 million multiply 15% per annum. Then what is the amount of total borrowing during the period we have used? 70 million. Then divide by 70 million. Right. Now 20 million multiply by 15%. Thirty million multiply 10% per annum, again 3 million. 20 million multiply by 15% per annum in case of overdraft facility, again another 3 million. So then divide total amount of borrowed funds used, then 9 divide 70, around 12.85%. That means you can understand this capitalization rate mean what, as I explained, is a weighted average of the borrowing cost. These are the total borrowing cost I used during the period, 70 million. Then how you can take the weighted average amount of this total borrowing? Take total borrowing cost incurred during the period, 20 million subject to 15%, 30 million multiply 10%, 20 million multiply 15%, divide 70 million. Then total borrowing cost used during the period, 9 million out of the 70. Then total borrowing the capitalization rate, that means weighted average of this borrowed funds, is 12.85%, right? So then this is the capitalization rate. Now after you calculate in the capitalization rate, how you can find the answer? What is the borrowing cost for the capitalization purpose, how you can calculate? Then the second step, you can identify subject to this capitalization rate. Now you can identify what is the total borrowing cost to be capitalized. The total the borrowing cost for capitalization equal, what is the total amount used? 50 million multiply capitalization rate 12.85%. So then during the period, the amount you should capitalize six point four two five percent. Right, 6 million. Sorry, not percent. We can say 6.425 million. This is the borrowing cost for the capitalization in case of the general borrowing. Right. The according to the LKS 23. Most important area you should consider how to calculate the borrowing cost for the capitalization. Again, I am explaining the specific borrowing. If it is a specific borrowing, that means you have borrowed funds 100% you use for only for qualifying asset. You have not used that borrowed fund for any other activities. So therefore, what you can do, according to my example, I want 50 million for the building. 50 million I multiply, only one loan I have taken, 10% per annum, 5 million. But I have some, because I am not paying entire amount at once to my contractor, I have some balance amount always with me during that period. So then I have invest that balance amount in the temporary investment, for example, 1 month fixed deposit. Then I have earned additional income 500,000. So then when you are going to calculate what is the borrowing cost for capitalization because of this qualifying asset, then out of this entire borrowing cost incurred, you should deduct this temporary investment income. So in this case, your borrowing cost amount for capitalization is 4.5 million. Now come to the general borrowing. General borrowing mean, again, yes, this general borrowing, now you have borrowed some amount, not only in one source, sometimes more than one, right? But for your qualifying asset purpose, for your building is a qualifying asset, you need 50 million again. But now you have not taken the one specific loan for this entire building, to construct this entire building. Now you have used the funds for this building. Out of this more than one, the borrowed funds taken to the business. But this amount you have borrowed not only for this qualifying asset, but to use that other business activities also. For example, working capital requirement also. Then example again, short-term loan 20 million, long-term loan, overdraft facility, then total amount you have taken 70. Then you have complete during the period by incurring 50 million qualifying asset also. Then, but practically there is a problem. If anybody asks, what is out of this 50 million, what is the amount you use from this short-term loan, long-term loan and overdraft facility? You can't answer. You don't know. But out of this 70 million, you have used 50 million. But these different borrowed funds, you have taken with the different interest rate. So in this case, we can say, yes, it's a general borrowing. So then this, in case of this general borrowing, to identify the borrowing cost for capitalization, you have to calculate capitalization rate. Capitalization rate. Then capitalization rate is what is the weighted average cost of these borrowed funds. Then how you can calculate the capitalization rate? Take total, the actual borrowing cost incurred related to this borrowed funds, divide out total borrowed amount. According to this example, we have incurred 9 million borrowing cost related to this entire 70 million borrowed funds. That's why we divide in 70. Then we have identified the common rate for this entire borrowed fund. Common rate means weighted average amount, 12.85%. Then by using this 12.85%, now subject to this general borrowing, we have calculated what is the borrowing cost to be capitalized on this building. 50 million, the amount used for the qualifying asset, you should multiply this capitalization rate. Amount is 6.425 million. That means 6,425 million. Now you can understand how to calculate borrowing cost for this capitalization purpose. Right. Okay. So normally the summary again I will explain in Sinhala also, right? What we did up to now. Borrowing cost may accounting standard ekata anuwa borrowing cost kiyanne apita dannawa borrowing cost kiyanne api කොහෙන් හරි ණයක් ගත්තට පස්සේ ඒ ණයට අපිට අමතරව ගෙවන්න වෙන මුදල. ඒකට අපි සාමාන්‍යයෙන් කියනවා මම මෙතන කිව්වා වගේ interest cost එක. interest poli අපි කියනවා poli කියලා. එතකොට ඒ poliට කරන ණය ගත්ත ණයට ගෙවන poli තමයි අපි කියන්නේ මේ borrowing cost එකක් කියලා. එතකොට ඔයා දන්නවා සාමාන්‍ය accounting treatment එක වෙන්නේ මොකද්ද poli වියදමට interest cost එකට ඔයා PNL එකට charge කරන්න ඕනේ under the finance cost. ඒක තමයි general accounting treatment එක. එතකොට එහෙම තියෙද්දි මොකටද මේ වෙනම accounting standard එකක් LKS 23 කියන්නේ? ඇයි මේ වෙනම කතා කරන්නේ? ඉතින් ඒක හරිම සරල accounting treatment එකක්. Normally interest cost we are charging to PNL. නමුත් මේ LKS 23 එකේ කියනවා if you have incurred the borrowing cost මේ interest cost එකක් ඔයා incur කරලා තියෙනවා නම් related to qualifying asset අපි use කරනවා qualifying asset ඒක තමයි මේ standard එකේ තියෙන key point එක borrowing cost එකක් incur කරලා තියෙන්නේ qualifying asset එකට නම් ඔයාට chance එකක් තියෙනවා ඒක PNL එකට charge නොකර ඒ interest cost එක PNL එකට debit නොකර expense එකක් විදියට recognize කරගන්න නැතුව ඒකේ qualifying asset එකේම කොටසක් විදියට add කරගන්න. ඒකට අපි කියනවා සරල වචනේ මොකද්ද capitalization. Without charging to the PNL you can add to the part of the cost of that asset. So then that's why the standard says any borrowing cost you incurred related to qualifying asset you can capitalize on it. එනම් මේ qualifying asset එකක් කියන්නේ මොකද්ද qualifying asset එකක් කියලා මම explain කරේ ඉස්සෙල්ලා ඕනම asset එකක් හැබැයි ඒක දැන් ඔයාගේ අවශ්‍යතාවයට නැහැ ඒ අවශ්‍යතාවයට ඒ asset එකපත් වෙන්න යම් කිසි කාලයක් ගත වෙනවා අපි ඒකට use කළා word එකක් considerable period of time to get ready for my intended use or sale ඒ කියන්නේ මේ qualifying asset එකක් කියන්නේ ඒක ඕනම asset එකක් ඒකට උදාහරණ මං කිව්වේ ඒක inventory එකක් වෙන්න පුළුවන් ඒක part of the property plant and equipment වෙන්න පුළුවන් like manufacturing plant නැත්නම් intangible asset එකක් වෙන්න පුළුවන් එතකොට මොකද්ද ඒකේ විශේෂත්වය මොකද්ද මේ qualifying asset එකක් කොහොමද ඔයා අඳුනගන්නේ asset එකක් ඔයාට අවශ්‍යයි නමුත් ඒක දැන් ඔයාගේ අවශ්‍යතාවයට අනුව නැහැ ඒ අවශ්‍යතාවයට අනුව ඔයාගේ පත් වෙන්න නම් intended use එකට එක්කෝ ඒ asset එක ඔයා පාවිච්චි කරන ඔයාගේ business එකේ නැත්නම් ඔයා කරන්නේ ඒක විකුණන්න යන්නේ intended use or sale එතකොට ඒ අවශ්‍යතාවයට අනුව පත් වෙන්න එකට යම් කිසි කාලයක් ගත වෙනවා ඒක it can be 3 month වෙන්න පුළුවන් 6 month වෙන්න පුළුවන් 1 year වෙන්න පුළුවන් 2 years වෙන්න පුළුවන් standard එකේ ඒක time එකක් refer කරලා නැහැ එතකොට ඔයාගේ අවශ්‍යතාවයට අනුව පත් වෙන්න යන කාලය අනුව ඒ qualifying asset එකක් වෙනවා එතකොට ඒකයි මම කිව්වේ ඔයාට බිල්ඩින් එකක් ඕනේ ඔයාට ඔප්ෂන් දෙකක් තියෙනවා එක්කෝ ඒ බිල්ඩින් එකක් දැන්ටමත් හදපු එකක් ගන්න පුළුවන් නැත්නම් ඔයාට කන්ට්‍රැක්ටර් කෙනෙක් හොයාගෙන අලුතෙන් එයාට කන්ට්‍රැක්ට් එකක් දීලා අලුතෙන් එකක් හදවන්න පුළුවන් එතකොට මේ දෙකෙන් ඔයා යනවනම් දැනටමත් හදපු බිල්ඩින් එකක් ගන්න ඒක ක්වොලිෆයින් ඇසෙට් එකක් නෙවෙයි මොකද ඒක දැන්ටමත් ඔයාගේ අවශ්‍යතාවය ෆුල්ෆිල් වෙලා ඉවරයි එතකොට ඒ ඩෙෆිනිෂන් එක ෆුල්ෆිල් වෙන්නේ නැහැ ඩෙෆිනිෂන් එක මැච් වෙන්නේ නැහැ නමුත් ඔයා බිල්ඩින් එකක් කන්ට්‍රැක්ටරට කන්ට්‍රැක්ට් එකක් දීලා හදන්න යනවනම් එහෙනම් ඒක දැනටමත් ඒ බිල්ඩින් එක ඔයාගේ අවශ්‍යතාවයට නැහැ. ඒකට යම්කිසි කාලයක් ගත වෙනවා. එහෙනම් ඒක අපි කියනවා qualifying asset එකක් කියලා. එතකොට මතක තියාගන්න මේ borrowing cost you can capitalize under this LKS 23 that borrowing cost you should incur in relation to the qualifying asset only. එතකොට ඒ qualifying asset එකකට අපි borrowing if you have already incurred the borrowing cost for the qualifying asset again right you have there is a specific borrowing and general borrowing එතකොට මේ borrowing cost එක අපි capitalize කරන්න යනකොට ඒක අපි calculate කරන්න ඕනේ ඒ calculate කරන්න ගියාම අපිට ප්‍රධාන ක්‍රම දෙකක් තියෙනවා method දෙකක් තියෙනවා එකක් තමයි specific borrowing අනිත් එක තමයි general borrowing specific borrowing කියන්නේ ඔයාට අවශ්‍ය ඒ qualifying asset එක හදන්න අවශ්‍ය full amount එකම ඔයා තනි ණයක් විදිහට ගන්නවා බැංකුවකින් ණය මුදලක් විදිහට ගන්නවා you need 50 million to construct the building ඔයා ඒ 50 million ම ගන්නවා බැංකුවෙන් ඒක යූස් කරන්නේ 100% only for that qualifying asset එතකොට එතනදී කොහමද borrowing cost එක calculate කරන්නේ actual borrowing cost incurred එතකොට සමහරලාට ඔයා ඒ 50 million බැංකුවෙන් ගත්තට එක පාටේ 50 million අපි දෙන්නේ නැහැ contractor ට building එක හදන්න කොටසක් විතරයි මුලදී දෙන්නේ ඊට පස්සේ ඒකේ complete එක අනු අපි යාට ගෙවනවා එතකන් ඒ අතේ තියෙන සල්ලි වාට temporary investment වලට යූස් කරන්න පුළුවන් 1 month fixed deposit එකක් දාන්න පුළුවන් එතකොට අනිත් temporary මේ වයින් ලැබුණු investment income එක වාට අඩු කරලා තමයි එන ගාණ අපි capitalization amount එකක් විදිහට යූස් කරන්නේ මෙතන general borrowing කිව්වේ මොකද්ද සමහර ලාට වාට 50 million ඕනේ වාගේ qualifying asset එක හදන්න financial period එකේ හැබැයි ඔයාට ඒ වෙනුවෙන්ම ලෝන් එකක් අරන් නැහැ. ඒ වෙනුවෙන්ම ලෝන් එකක් ගත්ත නම් ඒක ස්පෙસિෆික් බරෝවින් එකක් වෙනවා. දැන් ඔයා කරන්න යන්නේ වෙන වෙන පර්පස් වලට ගත්ත බරෝඩ් ෆන්ඩ්ස් වලින් ණය මුදල් වලින් තමයි අර ක්වොලිෆයින් ඇසෙට් එක හදලා තියෙන්නේ. ඒතකොට මේ උදාහරණය හොඳට බලන්න. ඔයා ගාව තියෙනවා ෂෝට් ටර්ම් ලෝන්, ලෝන් ටර්ම් ලෝන්, ඕවර්ඩ්‍රාෆ්ට් ෆැසිලිටි කියලා 70 මිලියන් ගත්ත සල්ලි. හැබැයි මේ 70 මිලියන් වලින් ඔයා පාවිච්චි කරලා තියෙනවා 50 මිලියන් for the qualifying asset. හැබැයි ඔයාට ඕනම අවස්ථාවක කියන්න බෑ මේ 50 මිලියන් මේ මිලියන 50 මේ මිලියන 20න් කොච්චරක් මේ 50 මිලියන් ඇතුලේ තියෙනවද 30න් කොච්චරක් තියෙනවද 20න් කොච්චරක් තියෙනවද ප්‍රැක්ටිකලි you can't say ඔයාට කියන්න බෑ ඒ නිසා අපි මොකද කරන්නේ මේ qualifying asset එක building එකේ අපිට capitalize කරන්න ඕන borrowing cost එක calculate කරන්න වෙන්නේ මේ වගේ අවස්ථාවක capitalization rate කියන concept එක use කරලා එතකොට මේ capitalization rate කියන්නේ මොකද්ද මේ ඔක්කොම borrowing funds වල weighted average amount එක. එතකොට මෙතන තියෙන්නේ ගණිතයේ සම්බන්ධ concept එකක්. එතනදී අපි කොහොමද කරන්නේ මේ ඔක්කොම borrowing වල actual borrowing cost එක calculate කරන්න. මේ short term loan, long term loan, overdraft facility වලට අදාළ ඔයා ගෙවපු පොලි මුදල් කීයද මේ අවුරුද්දේදී? एक वैडी करा 20 मिलियन 15% इंटरेस्ट 30 मिलियन 10% 20 मिलियन 15 वाली हरी सर लाई इड पास से अभी गत तो कुम्भ नायक मुदल वाले एक तो मिलियन है तय भाई इतने दिया अभी टेन वा पदु इंटरेस्ट रेट टेका कॉमन इंटरेस्ट रेट टेका एक अभी के ना कैपिटलाइजेशन रेट 12.85% එතකොට මේ 12.85% rate එක තමයි අපි කියන්නේ capitalization rate කියලා මෙන්න මේ general borrowing concept එකේදී. එතකොට එතනදී අපි මොකද කරේ මේ මේ 70 million වලින් use කරපු 50 million වලට අදාළ borrowing cost එක කීයද කියලා බලන්න මේ capitalization rate එකෙන් මේ use කරපු amount එක වැඩි කරා එතනදී අපිට ආවා 6 million 225 million amount එකක්. As a capitalization, as a borrowing cost for the capitalization purpose. So that's why the standard also explained like that. So borrowing cost for the eligible for the capitalization in minute under the borrowing cost eligible for the capitalization, the first part it cover about the specific borrowing. Second para cover about the general borrowing. So I have given all information, right? Now you know what is the meaning of borrowing cost, what is the meaning of the qualifying asset, and what is the key point and recognition criteria in this LKS 23. ඇයි අපි මේ 23 standard එක ගැන කතා කරන්නේ? ඒකට හේතුව මොකක්ද කියලා නෑ දැන් ඔයා දන්නවා. ඒ කියන්නේ qualifying asset එකකට ඉන්ක කරලා තියෙනවා නම් borrowing cost එකක්. Now we can capitalize that borrowing cost on the qualifying asset without charging to the P&L. Now you know how to calculate subject to this two method, specific borrowing and general borrowing also. Hari. Now there is another question. When you are going to apply this standard in case of the borrowing cost. For example, I will take this example. Right. As I explained, we need building. We need building. So the cost of this building is 50 million. Right? Construction period. The construction period construction period 1 year. Right? This entire 50 million you are going to funds as a borrowed funds. Right, taken from taken from bank loan. Right, for but to construct this building, it will take only 1 year period. 1 year period. Right, but what is the detail of this bank loan? Detail of this bank loan. Loan granted date 1st of January 2019. Right? Loan period 5 years. Subject to 10% interest per annum. Right. Take this example. Right. I am going to construct this building. Right. So, for the business purpose. So, then I have prepared the plan and given to the contractor. Contractor say, okay, I will complete this within 1 year period. Right, let's see construction. The construction period also. Right, construction period. You are going to start in 1st of April 2019 to, because only 1 year period. Up to 31st March 2020, right? But loan granted, loan received period, granted mean received period in first of date, 1st of January 2019. Because my contractor asking only 1 year period to complete this. Contractor start the construction work on 1st of April 2019, then issued a complete. If it is a 1 year period, 31st March 2020. But entire 50 million loan you have received 1st of January 2019. To settle this 50 million amount, loan bank has given 5 years period. You have to pay 1 month installment. That means 60 installment over this 5 years period. Interest rate is 10% per annum. Now, my question is, right, standard says, okay, if you are going to construct the building by using borrowed funds, then you have opportunity, according to the LKS 23, the borrowing cost incurred during the period, you can capitalize on this building, on this cost of this building. Right? So, but the loan period, loan you have received. Now, problem is, loan you have received in 1st of January 2019. Now, if the settlement period is 5 years, yes, the loan uh,
the last date of loan settlement is, we can identify 2019, 2020, 2021, 2022, 2023. Yes, 31st December 2023. Let's see, 2019-20. Right. You have, you want to pay, you want to pay the installment with interest up to 2020, December 31st. But this building is completed within 1 year, 31st March 2020. Then borrowing cost, that means interest cost you want to incur related to this building, related to this loan, from 1st of January 2019 to 31st December 2023, 5 years period. But building is completed within 1 year period. Then my question is, if you can, if you can capitalize this borrowing cost on this building, then what happened? The total borrowing cost, that means interest cost you incur after 31st March 2020. Because you can understand, out of this 5 years period, within 1 year period, the building is completed. But after complete this building also, you want to incur the borrowing cost continuously up to 31st December 2023. Then according to the standard, I want to know whether I can capitalize the borrowing cost incurred after completing this building also or not. Then what happened? Another point I want to tell you, the loan granted 1st of January 2019, that means you are liable to pay interest from the 1st of January 2019. You want to pay January month in this 2019, you want to pay interest for January month, February month, March month, April also you want to pay continuously up to 31st December. But can you see here, this building that contractor started to construct from 1st of April 2019, after 3 month period, loan received before 3 months, but you have started the construction from 1st of April 2019. Then what happened? The total interest cost incurred this during this 3 month period. There is a gap in 3 month period. You have, you are liable to pay interest to the bank for the first 3 months, January, February and March, but your building is start to construct from 1st of April onward. Then what happened, that interest cost you incurred during that first 3 month period? What is the accounting treatment? Can you capitalize on this building? Yes, we have now some problem. Even though you know, even though we discuss how to calculate the capitalization, the borrowing cost for capitalization on qualifying asset, then when you are going to apply that calculation, you have to consider another criteria also. Number one, when we can start the capitalization on this borrowing cost? Are there any date to stop that capitalization? Then when you can start the capitalization and when you should stop the capitalization or cessation of capitalization, we want to discuss. Because now you have some doubt. Yes, what happened for that first 3 month interest cost? Because I am liable to pay interest cost, but still construction is not started. It has started after 3 month period. Another question is what? Because according to this loan agreement with bank, I want to pay loan installment up to 31st December 2023, 5 years time period, but my building is completed as at 31st March 2020. Right? So, but after 31st March 2020, still I want to pay interest to the bank. Then what happened, that balance after the interest cost you are going to incur after 31st March 2020 up to 31st December 2023? Can you capitalize on this building? according to this LKS 23, right? So now we have that problems. Now we are going to find the answer for that questions. Okay, number one, what are the criteria and conditions to be satisfied in order to start this capitalization? Number one, in this tut you can see in the first page I have given commencement of capitalization. Okay, these are the conditions should be satisfied to commencement or start the capitalization. Very important, to start the capitalization these are the conditions should be satisfied, right? Commencement of capitalization. Number one, incurs expenditure for the qualifying asset. For the qualifying asset, this is the number one condition should be satisfied, right? Qualifying asset, right? What is the second one? Incurs borrowing cost mean interest cost. You are liable to pay cost to the bank, interest cost to the bank. That is the second one. Third one, third condition should be satisfied, what? The physical right. Third condition start physical activities. Of the qualifying asset, right? Okay, these are the three conditions should be satisfied to start the capitalization. Now you can find the answer for my questions, right? First one, first you should incur the expenses for the qualifying asset, right? That means what? You should start to incur the expenses for this building, right? Then next one, incurs the borrowing cost, interest cost. That means you should liable to pay bank loan, the interest to the bank. That means what happened? In order to start the capitalization, you must taken the bank loan and you are liable to pay. You should sign the agreement, then you are liable to pay interest also. Then third one is what? You must start the physical activities to construct this building. Then only you can start the capitalization for the borrowing cost, right? Now you can understand if the standard says so. In order to start the capitalization of borrowing cost during the period, right? If that entity should incur the cost to construct this building, and you are liable to pay borrowing cost also, right? and you must start these physical activities also. Entire three conditions should be satisfied. Then my first question is what? When I can start the capitalization? Because I have taken in this example. Now, read this criteria again. Come to this example, right? To start the capitalization, again, yes, we have to incur expenses for the qualifying asset. Let's see, my qualifying asset is building. I have given the contract to the contractor. He should start to incur the cost. That means, for example, in my side, I want to pay only advance. Yes, if I have paid advance to my contractor, yes, I have incurred expenses on this qualifying asset. Yes, first condition satisfied. Then what is the meaning of incur the borrowing cost mean? That means I should, the amount need for my qualifying asset, I have already taken from the bank loan, from the bank or another borrowing, any other financial institution as a borrowed funds, and I should liable to pay the interest also. That is the incur for borrowing cost. Then third one is what? Start the physical activities of the qualifying asset. That means, yes, I have paid advance to the contractor, but contractor should start physical activities in this to construct this building. That means ground preparation and other thing he should start. Then if this entire three conditions satisfied only, we can start the capitalization of borrowing cost on the qualifying asset. In this example, what I explain, yes, I have taken bank loan in advance. That means in 1st of January 2019, I have signed the agreement with the bank. Amount also credited to me. Now I have 50 million in this date. From this date onward, I am liable to pay 10% interest to the bank. Then this condition satisfied, we are in first of this condition satisfied. What is the date? 1st of January 2019. Can you see? 1st of January 2019, this condition satisfied first. Then what happened? But here, my qualifying asset was started to complete, the construction was started in 1st of April 2019. Let's see, I have paid after I received this 1st of January amount 50 million from bank in 1st of January 2019. I will add another point here. I have paid advance to contractor in 1st of February 2019. I have paid advance to contractor rupees 10 million. Let's see, 10 million. Then what happened? Advance also paid. Yes, I have incurred expenses for qualifying asset as advance in 1st of February 2019. But even though I paid advance in 1st of February 2019, my contractor has started the work. That means ground preparation, starting from foundation and other activities, he has started from 1st of April 2019. Then this, the last point, start the physical activity in 1st of April 2019. Now what happened? According to my example, all these three activities are not completed in a single date. Because first, it was started to incur the interest cost as a borrower from 1st of January. Then I have paid advance to my contractor 1st of February 2019. Then my contractor start the physical work, and after another 2 months, 1st of April, start the physical activities. Now what happened? When I can start the capitalization then? Yes, I can start the capitalization of borrowing cost after completing entire these three activities only. Then you can see all these three activities has been completed on 1st of April 2019, right? Because the latest date you want to take, right? Even though I incur the interest expense from 1st of January 2019, because in that date, these two activities is not completed. Out of these two activities, the first one was completed in 1st of February. Even though these two is now completed as at 1st of April 2019, this condition was satisfied after 2 months, 1st of April 2019. Then according to the standard, I can capitalize the borrowing cost in this qualifying asset only in 1st of April 2019, right? Then what happened? The interest cost you paid for January, February and March month. That's 3 month interest expense, borrowing cost, you must charge to the P&L as a finance expense. You can't capitalize, right? Okay, so then now you can read the commencement of the capitalization. The entity shall begin the capitalization of borrowing cost as a part of the cost of that qualifying asset commencement date, and the commencement for the capitalization is the date when the entity first need all following condition. Yes, you should highlight and you should underline this point. Commencement date for the capitalization is the date when first meet all of these following condition. Yes, according to my example, all of these condition was satisfied in this date, right? Then identify, incur the expenditure of for the cost and incur the borrowing cost. Then last one is what? The physical activities also should be satisfied. That means undertake activities that are necessary to prepare the asset of the need for the sale. So now you can understand apita borrowing cost eka qualifying asset eke capitalize karanna kavadada api karanna one kiyala eka thirine wenne me condition tunama satisfy unu dawase hari etoda edata thamai me man owata kiwwe api borrowing cost capitalize borrowing cost එක calculate කරන්නේ කොහොමද කියලා අපි discuss කරා. ඒක two part තියෙනවා. Again general borrowing, specific borrowing කියලා. හැබැයි අපි කවදද මේ borrowing cost capitalization කරන්න පටන් ගන්නෙ? මොනවද ඒකට condition satisfy වෙන්න ඕනේ? ඒතර වට තේරෙනවා ඇති මේ condition තුන තමයි satisfy වෙන්න ඕනේ. හැබැයි මේ තුනම complete වුණු දවසට තමයි අපිට borrowing cost එක qualifying asset එකේ capitalize කරන්න අවස්ථාව හම්බ වෙන්නේ. එතකන් ඉන්ක කරන ඕනම borrowing cost එකක් we should identify, we should charge to the P&L as a normal finance expense or interest expense. It's a very important thing, right? Okay.